This weekend, Ohio State crushed Michigan State while Alabama struggled to win at home against Arkansas. What are the chances the Buckeyes jump the Crimson Tide for that number two spot tonight?
Strong, Max. And I think Buckeyes last week said that the Spartans kissed the baby. That's why I got the crib in the background, man. It's not because I'm at my in-laws' house for Thanksgiving. It's not that at all. I'm looking at the Buckeyes, man, and what I saw from them last week was a complete performance, not just offensively, where we know they're a juggernaut. They got three unbelievable wide receivers. They have the Heisman front runner at quarterback. And they have an unbelievably gifted true freshman at running back. But what we saw from Ohio State was that passing attack that got going early against what was a completely overmatched Michigan State pass defense, which came into that game as 130th in college football. We also saw Ohio State's defense completely shut down what was the best running back in college football, Kenneth Walker. Now, he didn't get enough cracks at it. He only had six carries in the game, which I still can't comprehend. However, Ohio State, that was a complete performance against a top 10 team, which I think will justify moving them ahead of Alabama, who just got by looking a little average on defense against Arkansas.
I mean, let's be honest. When was the last time the dream matchup for the championship at this late date in the season did not involve Alabama? Because right now you want to see the Georgia defense, the Ohio State offense. All right, game of the week on Saturday as Ohio State faces their angry little brother, number six Michigan. Jim Harbaugh is famously 0-5 against the Buckeyes as the Wolverines head coach. Does he have a chance to get off the schneid this weekend, Greg?
Wait, Max, hang on. You're telling me Jim Harbaugh's never beat the Buckeyes? That's been a topic of conversation or a narrative for a while now. I look at this and I actually think, as crazy as this may sound, and maybe I haven't hit the brown water or anything today. I mean, I'm being very, very focused. I actually believe this. I think Michigan matches up pretty well. As crazy as that sounds, I think Michigan has the personnel along the defensive front to be able to create some problems with their pass rush. But most notably, Michigan can control the line of scrimmage and run the football. Ohio State's defense has at times this year been susceptible against teams that want to impose their will on the ground. That's what Michigan is. They have a 1-2 punch at running back that's as good as anybody in college football. You got Blake Corum, who's number two. He's unbelievable. Very, very athletic. Reminds me of the muscle hamster back in the day. A little bit shorter, but very stocky. And then you got Hassan Haskins, who does a great job on the perimeter, but can also get downhill. I think those two complement each other beautifully. And I'd be highly surprised if Jim Harbaugh didn't put together a plan that made sure that each one of those guys got 15 to 20 touches each. That's what they have to do to win the game. They got to shrink it. They got to keep the ball away from Ohio State's offense, and they got to be able to impose their will along the line of scrimmage.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.